Good morning, dear students of class 10. In previous videos, we were also discussed Hale's theorem and what of Hale's theorem and angle bisector theorem is concerned. Now we discuss some portions of exercise 4A. 2-1. By this portion is D and E are points on the sides AB and AC, respectively of a triangle ABC, such that DE and BC find the value of X when AD equal to X centimeter, DB equal to X minus 2 centimeter, and AB equal to X plus 2 centimeter, and EC equal to X minus 1 centimeter. So, dear student, we have given DE parallel BC. DE parallel BC. If third side of a triangle is parallel to third side, if a side parallel to third side, then by using this theorem, AD upon DB equal to AD upon DC. Put the values of AD, AE, DB and EC. X upon X minus 2 equal to X plus 2 by X minus 1. After cross multiplication, X into X minus 1 equal to X plus 2 into X minus 2. Solve X into X, X square, X into minus 1, minus X equal to. We know that A plus B into A minus B equal to A square minus B square. The formula. By using this formula, A plus B into A minus B, here value of A is X and B is 2. So we write X square minus 2 square. X square, 2 square means 2 to the 4, that's minus 4. X square, and here also X square. If we change X square, there are just 2 edges. One is plus and another is minus, so we eliminate X square and X square. Here minus X and minus 4. Minus minus cancel, X equal to 4. This is the value of X, and the value of X is 0.4 centimeter. And next question is, dear student, question number 4. In a triangle ABC, AD is the bisector of angle A. First question of 4 is, if AB equal to 6.4 centimeter, if AB equal to 6.4 centimeter, AC equal to 8 centimeter, AB equal to 6.4 centimeter, AB equal to 8 centimeter, and BD equal to 5.6 centimeter, then you find DC equal to what? We know that if AD is the bisector of angle A, AD is the bisector of angle A, that means angle BAB equal to angle DAC. These angles are equal. Then we use angle bisector theorem. Dear student, we already studied angle bisector theorem. AB upon AC equal to BD upon BC. Substitute all the given values of this formula. AB equal to 6.4, AC equal to 8 centimeter, BD equal to 5.6 centimeter, and DC equal to BC, because this is unknown point. After solving this point is eliminated, then 8 7 is 64. 8 7 is 57. Dear student, After cross multiplication is 1 dc into 1 equal to 7 into 1 dc equal to 7 centimeter. Here is friend. So dc equal to 7 centimeter. Okay. And now next question is. Dear student, now another question is question number 9. Show that the line segment which joins the midpoint of the oblique means this type of line, oblique, and this is straight line. Size of a trapezium is parallel to the parallel side. That means we prove BC parallel here. Okay. Now we given let ABCD be the trapezium. ABCD is the trapezium, and E and F are the midpoints of AB and BC respectively. Dear students, that means E is the midpoint of this oblique side AB and F is the midpoint of this oblique side BC. Okay, now construction. Proceed AB up to P and BC up to P and they meet at both at P. That will produce AB and BC to meet at P. Dear students, prove. This is a very important question for your examination. If triangle PAB denote at parallel side, in fact in trapezium, opposite one pair of sides is parallel to each other. And so BC is parallel to AB because AB and BC are oblique side. Okay, so BC parallel AB. This is parallel AB. Now, in triangle PAB, BC is parallel to AB. Then we use Hill's theorem. By using Hill's theorem, according to Hill's theorem, what? PD upon BA equal to PC upon CB. Okay? But we know that E is the midpoint of AD. So we put here AE equal to EB, that means AE plus EB equal to AD, and in the speed of AE we put ED also, so EB plus ED equal to AD and 2ED equal to AD, so we put AD equal to 2DE. Similarly, we put BC equal to 2CL. BC equal to 2CL. Okay? 2 cancel. PD upon DE equal to PC upon CL. PD upon DE equal to PC upon CL. That means D and C are the points lies on PE and PF respectively. So, after using a convolution of this theorem by using convolution of Hill's theorem, we prove DE parallel EF. Dear student, chapter 4 is complete. Kindly solve all the question answer to given process and solve also examples question 1 to 30. For more updates, stay tuned. Thank you very much.